Welcome back to Dreamfall Chapters, Book 3. It's time to go to the Rooster and Kitten. But before that, I want to know why I can examine the shrubbery behind me. What is so special about the shrubbery? Tell me, Keon.
Shrubbery of some sort. I haven't studied my Mercurian plants, but they appear quite ordinary.
Alrighty then.
This pipe has a hinged panel in it, but I'll need a tool to open it.
I'm guessing I'm gonna have to open that, probably quite soon. But at the moment I have no idea why I would want to mess with it, so let's not do that. Excuse me, sir. Do you need help getting inside of your home?
Can you feel me breathing down your neck?
Stacks of hay to represent the harvest festival, the reaping.
I love this creature. Was that a goat? I don't know what the heck that was, but I love this thing. I don't know what it is, but I like it. And I want to ride it to faraway lands and go on adventures. I want to tug on its jowly things. I think it's supposed to be eating the grass. That or it's just yawning. Is that the thing that made the goat noise? It looks like a demonic cat. In fact, it even has little horns. It's got little horns and it has red eyes. What are you? It's kind of cute, though. I want to pet it.
It's surprisingly quiet out. Usually these tables are busy until late at night. Granted, it is chilly and damp. Everyone's probably inside, carousing.
The way he said that, such dripping scorn from his words. Inside, carousing.
It'd be easier to walk around unnoticed if there were more people about. But I do get to operate in peace.
Seriously, did that come from this thing, or is there a goat somewhere and I just don't see it? Oh, there are goats! Hey!
What was that herb the mole spoke of? Evensong. This must be it. It's an opiate. Consume enough and you fall asleep.
So, are they falling asleep on opium? Relaxing. Anyway, we have somewhere to be, don't we?
Your basic shrubbery. Shrubberish.
Did one of the developers have, like, a thing for shrubbery? They put in a description for every individual shrub? Or is it... It's probably gonna be a quest thing, isn't it?
It's surprisingly quiet out. Usually these tables are busy until late at night. Granted, it is chilly and damp. Everyone's probably inside, carousing. The wreaths are part of the harvest festival tradition.
You see that gentleman sitting over there? Don't look, you simpletons. Balance. You lot don't know much about subterfuge, do you? That man's an Azadi mechanic. He drinks here most nights, but I didn't know that part until I overheard him speaking to his friend earlier about the pipes. Seems that with the pipe network up and running, there's a lot of tinkering to be done. Our man over there carries a tool to open maintenance hatches.
If we can get inside a hatch...
We can maybe figure out what they're using the pipes for. That's brilliant, Ulvik.
So we slit his throat and dump him in the bay?
Not in my bar, you won't.
If they find out we've taken his tools, the information could turn out to be useless. No. We need to...
Borrow his tools, open one of those pipes to have a look-see, and put the tools back before he notices. And that was probably what you were going to say when I interrupted you. Sorry.
If you can do it without him noticing, I won't stop you. But if the Azadi ever suspect that I'm collaborating with the Resistance...
That will not happen, Ulvik.
So what do we do, Kian?
What we do is I go adjust the volume of the game because for some reason it's suddenly become really, really loud to me. I'll be right back. Alright, there we go. Now I can actually hear myself think.
Ulvik brought this to our attention. It's only fair that I include him in the decision. The others look to me for leadership now. It's important that I take charge and make the decisions.
Do I want to take charge? That's a lot of responsibility. I don't like responsibility. Let's defer.
What do you think, Ulvik?
Me? Well, I think you three are resourceful in different ways. Instead of bickering about what to do, which is what usually happens, why not split up? There's every chance that one of you will come up with something that doesn't involve murder, the total destruction of my pub, or blowing my cover.
I agree.
We can't take too long. That man won't stay here forever.
He's on his second drink. He usually doesn't leave until he's had at least three. And I can offer a few on the house to make him stay longer.
It's decided then. We'll meet again here later this evening.
Winner buys a round for everyone. No? No? It's not very motivating? Okay.
So who's the one to steal the tools? Is that going to be me? Find some way to incapacitate the pipe maintenance worker. Wait, incapacitate? I thought we were just going to steal his tools without him noticing. Am I supposed to knock him out?
Ulvik is a good man. I enjoy his company. He's true to his word. I trust him with my life and consider him a friend.
I should probably talk to him, actually.
Have you found anything yet?
I'm working on it.
Enno and Nico are still out looking. And you're not. You should get to it.
Hold on, okay. So I'm guessing, given that he likes to drink, and given that I just saw the opium plant, I'm guessing I need to put some of that into his drink. To make him pass out and then steal his tools.
Ulvik doesn't have the most sophisticated or upscale
clientele. Just one more. One more for the road.
I'm sure he's happy.
A bit of Dolmari courage to help me get started. And then I'll head home.
You always talk to yourself.
At least they're not.
You wouldn't believe the amount of work that's required to keep the network running smoothly. Oh, the engineering's good, but the assembly's... Don't put military men on a civilian job, is all I'm saying. This requires fine skill, not brute force. See, if the connection between the pipes are off by even a hair's breadth, the orbs can start rattling around and get stuck. If that happens, Shadow, let's just say the tower would be severely displeased. The official opening's in a week, and they want the ceremony to go as smoothly as possible. The emissary would not take kindly to being embarrassed in front of the first. So that leaves me and the workbox.
Ew. He said if the connection's off by even a tiny bit, the orbs might rattle around and get stuck.
The witch and the vicar.
So that's what's going to be transferred through the tubes, is orbs? What kind of orbs and what do they do?
Shots of liquor and presently wing for a walk.
They appear to be having a good
time. The worst thing is crawling in the tubes. What do you call them here? Rats. I had to clean out rat gizzards from a junction last week. Shadow take me, what a mess that was. See, once the blood and guts get into the engines, there's nothing for it. They need to be dismantled and every piece has to be scrubbed clean.
That is gross.
Takes a full day, that does. I wish they'd put some sort of safeguards in place. There are rats crawling all over this goddess-forsaken city. You know how many times I've seen a crawler in Sedae? None. None is the times.
They're good people. Bless their generous hearts. There are mostly labourers and dock workers.
Those tubes will make our lives better.
It's the perfect cover for the resistance.
How's that?
Well, they're there for the,
traditional wheat moon snacks.
Humankind, aren't they?
Roasted apples.
What does that
even mean?
Salted
yams. Sweet roots.
Life's a
pungent,
series
fermented
of tubes.
Snapjaw eggs.
I'll drink to that.
That sounds really good, except for maybe the pungent eggs. That sounds kind of nasty. I know I'm supposed to go outside, but I want to know what's upstairs.
Alvik doesn't have the most sophisticated or upscale clientele, and I'm sure he's happy about that. At least the
fucking rebels are in trouble. Mercurius just looks the same
without
Shh.
Honor Hilaris is right. We're better
off without
them.
You. Is this the best place to lament the loss of magicals?
Well, we have lost something, haven't we? Is this town really better off without magicals? Be honest.
Honesty is the quickest way to the noose.
I love how they continue to talk about stuff that they shouldn't talk about when I'm, like, literally breathing down his neck. I'm such a creeper. But at least I don't sizzle and explode. Alright, let's go get some drugs.
Before our arrival, the street lamps were lit with magic spells. They've been replaced with modern electricity.
What exactly are you doing to that goat? Wait, does this have anything to do with why you rejected me? Goats? Honestly?
What do you mean by goats and honestly? I don't understand your words, woman.
Oh my god,
hey,
Keon.
I'm not judging anyone. I'm just surprised is all.
Where have you been this past month?
Away. Far away. Travelling, so...
This goat, what's going on here?
It's rebel business.
Clearly. How's that working out for you? Are you one of them now?
The goats?
I'm atoning for my sins.
Right. But you are enjoying it.
I don't enjoy fighting my own people.
Well, you seem to be good at it. Word is the resistance is gaining support, that people have hope now that you're there.
I'm doing what I can to help.
I heard you went soft on our vile little Azadi officer. If I'd known, I would have taken care of him myself. Not killing him makes some sense, a source in the tower and all, but forgoing torture, that's just a missed opportunity. The thing about torture is that it's a seal of authenticity. It makes every piece of information more reliable.
No, it doesn't.
I understand your friends didn't take the officer's word for it. Well, even if you didn't pull out of Old Town, at least the Resistance put up a decent fight before... The important thing is, many Azadi died that night. Chalice half full and all that.
What do you want?
Nothing. Nothing. I saw you. It's been a while. I wanted to say hello. Oh, I've missed this. The one-sided conversations. The sullenness and suspicion. I've come to enjoy it quite a bit. Anyway, goats,
We have a lead on the pipes.
Oh, that explains everything. I'll leave you to it then. I'm going to the Rooster later tonight. I need to speak with Ulvik. Maybe I'll see you there.
Maybe.
This is what I love about you, Kian. You're such a people person.
Kian sure is a man of many, many words. Such a poet. Bring the Evensong to Ulvik, yeah. Alright, so I think he's just gonna brew it inside of the beer or something. Well, I mean, you can't really brew it because the beer is cold, right? I mean, technically you can cold brew, but it's a lot slower than a hot brew. Maybe he's just gonna grind it up. We'll see what he does with it.
Ulvik is a good man. I enjoy his company. He's true to his...
This is Evensong. It works on goats.
Well then, it should work on the Azadi too, eh?
Are you saying the Azadi are just the same as goats? Because that's kind of insulting to goats.
One more ale on the house, da?
Ah, what a lovely head. This one smells different. Malty, sweet. It's almost like the sugar ale from Southern as a day.
Let's non-suspiciously watch from this pillar here.
Now, this is a brew, Ulvik. Tastes like home, this does. It brings tears to my eyes. It's simply spect...
Wait, I can touch him? What am I gonna do? Steal his wallet?
Hey. Hey!
I guess he's out. Good. Anything else I need? He's got some other tools in there. Sure you don't want a hammer? No? Okay.
Don't take too long out there. If he wakes up without his tools, there'll be questions and I won't have any good answers.
Alright, gotta do it fast. Gotcha. I don't know if this game actually has a timer. It wouldn't surprise me if it did. So I should be reasonably fast. Let's not stop and smell the roses here. Okay. Investigate the pipes. Could look at the map, but I already know where one of them is. Or at least where one of the access points are. So let's go to that one first. Need to remember how to use my inventory. There we go.
There's a powerful wind blowing from right to left, and it carries something with it. Too quick to see, too fast to grab.
I'm guessing if I had something, I could catch it, right? Something to stop it. Like if I could stuff something inside of the pipe, some sort of a stopper. I know. We can stuff the shrub inside of it.
Shrubbery of some sort.
Damn it.
I haven't studied my Mercurian.
Stuff the map in there.
They appear
no?
Quite
okay.
Ordinary.
Where am I on this map? I must be on the bottom left one, right? Yeah, it's gotta be. Alright, so the other pipe. I believe is straight ahead and a little bit to the right. Yeah, and I need to be on the lookout for something that I might be able to catch that orb with. Like... Maybe a hay fork?
Stacks of hay to represent the harvest festival. The reaping.
Apparently not, but I feel like that might work. Hey, demon cat thing. Oh, there's multiple demon cats. Cool.
A pumpkin.
What if I stuff a pumpkin in there?
Vegetable. It's surprisingly quiet out.
A cup?
It's surprisingly quiet.
The demon cat?
Usually these tables are busy until late at night. Granted, it is chilly and damp. Everyone's probably inside, carousing. There's air flowing from right to left, like a tempest in a tube. Looks empty. There's a strong current of air flowing through it.
He did talk about rats getting stuck inside of it and messing up the engines. And I did see some rats. I'm not supposed to stuff rats inside and make them explode, am I? Because, I mean, here's some rats. Alright, where's the other tube? It's somewhere around here. I think. Oh, it's actually back here. Where's the access point for it? I don't really know how far down that is. I feel like I'm going too far, though. I'm pretty sure I'm going too far. Yo, dude. Not suspicious at all, just going out for a nighttime jog. Not here. Alright, yeah, I went too far.
Honor Hillaris has posted these bills everywhere. He's serious about his run for office. Under his leadership, the City Watch will fester and rot.
Am I supposed to go up here? I thought I couldn't climb these stairs. Yeah, I can. Where in the heck is it? It looks like it's halfway down the street. And it's on this side. And this, like, right here is halfway down the street. Perhaps Keon is simply too short to reach it. I'm missing something obvious. I've probably already gone by it. Oh, wait a minute, is that it? That is an access point, but it's too high up. It's also on the wrong side of the street. Goals updated. Investigate the pipes and investigate the object passing through the pipes. Yeah, I figured. Figured I needed to do that.
They've put up ornaments all over town for the Festival of Reaping. Harvest season is important in the Northlands.
Should I abandon my pursuit for the last access point? Does it not matter anymore? Do you not need to access all access points?
It's a map of the pipe network, with maintenance hatches marked in red.
I'm gonna take a look around to see if I could find the last access point. And I'll be right back. Well, I couldn't find the other access point, but I did just find this box of pipe parts. Which is probably gonna come in handy. It's probably what I need to stop the thing. It's funny, this is... they're doing, like, the same puzzle they did before. Like, what was it? I think it was the last book, wasn't it? Where I had to blow up the stack of stuff out here on the docks. And, pretty much every single thing that I needed to blow it up was right here. Like, even this exact item. Right here, this barrel of oil. It's like the same puzzle over again. More open crates of stuff that I'm just stealing. Like, maybe that's the access point. Maybe you're just not really supposed to access the access point? Or something?
I don't know.
I don't know why it'd be listed on the ladder if you can't access it. Maybe you're supposed to use a ladder. I don't know why it'd be listed on the map if you can't use it. Maybe you're supposed to use a ladder to reach it, but... it's a bit bizarre. Okay, so can I, like, take... how do I take a pipe section off?
Oh, that didn't accomplish anything.
Yeah, okay,
whatever's
not gonna
in
work.
There just bounces off the pipe.
That is gonna go shooting out. Alright, there we go. That actually didn't go as far as I thought it would. Take that back. Don't want to leave it clogged up. Only need one ball.
A metal ball? That's what's flying through these pipes? Where did the orb come from? I should investigate where this pipe leads. Hopefully to some answers.
Yeah, what's the point in transporting orbs? Looks like it's supposed to connect to stuff.
These orbs rattle through the pipes like bullets through barrels.
Alright, let's follow it. So it came from this direction. This is where the orb came from.
Need to find a way into that building tonight.
Well, I can just go through without them noticing me, right? Aren't I still invisible?
There's official Azadi business going on here. You'll want to turn around and walk away.
Oh, I guess not. You mean that potion doesn't last forever? Dang it. Can I sneak up?
The pipe carrying the metal orb leads into that building. I knew it was important.
I mean, I could just climb up this dang rock. Like, I could easily get myself up there. Follow the pipes to find out where the metal sphere came from. Well, like... kind of already know that. I know where it came from. The problem is actually investigating it.
Go on now. No.
What if I try again?
Marshal, were you here when we had that horrible mess the other day?
I don't think so.
One of them, what are they called? Them ground crawlers.
Rats?
That's it, rats. One of them rats got into the pipes. Whoop! Got sucked right into the engine.
Whoa. That doesn't sound good.
Light, what a bloody mess. Literally. Guts, bones, hair, blood everywhere. I had to shut things down. And it was us who had to clean it. Engineers wouldn't touch it, said their hands are too valuable. I guess ours aren't.
It's a soldier's lot, isn't it? We do the grunt work. That's how it goes.
Well, I guess they think cleaning out rat guts is more important than us keeping watch and protecting them engineers in there.
Eh, guess so.
So do I need to make a mess?
A pumpkin. An odd vegetable. Native to the Northland. We have nothing like it in Azadir.
So what am I gonna shove in the pipes? I want to shove like a pumpkin. I don't want to shove a rat. That's mean.
Apparently, the reaping's the right time for pumpkins, and they're an important part of the celebrations. Goddess knows why. They're hideous things. They can't be wild goats, not in the middle of Mercuria. But who owns them? The city? Maybe this is how they keep the grass in the green trimmed. Looks empty. There's a strong current of air flowing through it.
So this one doesn't have any orbs, but it is still moving. What if I put an orb in here?
It's light for a metal ball. And these markings and studs, they're highly intricate. It's a beautifully crafted device.
Apparently I can't actually use it. On the access panel.
The gale's blowing from right to left.
In fact, I can't seem to use anything on it. Yeah, I can't. Does it have anything to do with these rats? Huh? What? Who? I don't know who just called my name, but leave me alone.
So we meet again,
Zardy. Oh, hey, Bip.
Prepare your blade for battle.
Goddess, it's late, boy. You should be in bed.
So should you. What you doing now? Chasing rats?
Mm-hmm.
The boy appears genuinely interested. I've been told this is rare in children. Perhaps I shouldn't discourage him.
Oh, Keon.
Yes, that's exactly what I'm doing.
Are you that hungry? Rats taste like sewage. Trust me, you're better off eating table scraps.
I'm not eating the rat. I need it for... It's work-related. It is.
Okay. Well, don't let me keep you from your rats.
Are you just going to sit there?
It's not every night I get a chance to watch you catch a rat.
Fair point.
You could help me catch a rat. Come on, don't be picky, Keon.
They're too quick.
You're not very good at catching rats, are you?
Maybe you should help me.
It's a leftover cheese and meats plate. I've dined here. The food's good. I would never have left any bits uneaten.
Maybe if I feed them.
They won't come close as long as I'm standing here.
Oh, pff, Jesus. That was fast.
Oh, so close. Well, not really.
Thanks for the help, Bip. Can I get more opiate plant and just, like, make them eat cheesy opium. I don't think the opium is the solution here, but just in case. Oh, okay, maybe it is. Can I combine them? There we go. Opiated cheesy bits. Mmm.
Here's some particularly potent cheese. Filthy shadow spawn. Eat it. Eat it all.
They won't come close as long as I'm
still. He really doesn't like rats. Filthy shadow spawn. Alright. You're the slow one. There we go.
I don't know. And I don't care. It's a rat, and it's not moving.
You got it! I really didn't think you would. I'm impressed. Well, that was fun. What's next?
Next, you go home and stop distracting me, or I'll tell the other street urchins you have fleas.
I have no home. You know that. I sleep in the cellar of the Rooster and Kitten.
Good. It's the safest place around. So go back to your cellar and keep your head down. If I see you again tonight...
Fleas, got it. I'm sleepy anyways. That's why I'm going back. Not because you're telling me to.
And don't throw pebbles at Azadi soldiers.
Okay, so am I actually supposed to obliterate this rat and cause a mess that... Oh... I don't want to do that. Why can't I just use a pumpkin? Why can't I just hack off a piece of a pumpkin and just shove it in there? Yeah, I'm supposed to use it. Rest in peace, filthy shadow spawn.
What was that sound? It was a squishy sound, sort of like...
You've got to be kidding me. Not again. Shut a damn ground crawlers.
I guess it's on us to clean up the mess.
That bloody engineer in there is not going to do it. So yeah, it's on us.
Light. Well, let's get to it. No time like the present.
Yay, I solved a puzzle by exploding a harmless rat. It's okay, don't think about it, keep your chin up. We're solving a mystery. The mystery of why Keon is such a piece of shit. What the hell? That's not what I expected to find. What is that readout? What are all those displays showing? How could you even read that information fast enough to do anything with it? Feels like some sort of, like, number crunching station. As if they're trying to crack a code or something.
Someone's down there. More metal tubes leading down to these odd tables.
So is this where the balls come from, or where they go? This is where it came from, right? So the balls are sent out from here? I mean, perhaps it's both. Maybe they're sent out and they also return.
I wonder what'll happen when I push one of these knobs. Oh, that's ominous.
More balls. Balls and balls and balls.
I don't know what these are, but they put me in mind of a lady's vanity. Except with knobs. Lots and lots of knobs.
Let's see what happens.
I wonder what'll happen when I push one of these knobs. I wonder what'll happen when I push one of these knobs.
So, why don't you do it? Ominous.
I wonder what'll...
Okay, he's not going to do it. Happen when fine. Fine.
That's on. More of those... More of those odd metal orbs. They're doing something to them here. Altering them. There's mathematics on that board.
It's a, like, kind of blown-out drawing of the orb, right? It looks like there's stuff inside of it. Intricate stuff, I think. It's hard to tell.
You're not supposed to be here. This place is for engineers only. Please leave or I'll be forced to call the guards. I have a very loud voice when I'm scared.
One sound, and you'll be standing on the slopes of the first mountain, yelling at clouds.
Goddess. No problem. I'll be quiet as a... You're from Azadir. I've seen your profile in embroideries. I never forget a nose. You're the Apostle. Apostle Elvani. You're famous.
Maybe once. Now I'm just Kian. Your turn.
My turn what?
Your name. Who are you?
Ferdows. I'm Ferdows. Lead engineer.
I don't know what that means. What do you do?
Don't you know? I thought you would have known. You know, from back when you were... I'm in charge of the team that encodes the spheres that make the engine tick.
What engine?
The engine that... You know, the engine. There's only one engine. The one that encompasses the entire city. It's what all the pipes are connected to. Didn't they tell you anything when you were... You know, before you were a traitor?
Assume that I know nothing. What is this engine for?
The engine calculates. That's why they call it the calculating engine. Big numbers, complex equations. My team, we give the engine instructions about how and what to calculate. This is called coding.
I understood none of that.
You can't be here. You're a fugitive, and this is a restricted zone. That's like two things that mean you shouldn't be here, and I could probably think of more if you need me to.
I have a sword, and I'm bigger than you.
Those are two things that count in your favor, granted.
So what does this calculating engine do? What's its purpose?
I'm really not supposed to. Right. Bigger and sword. As I said, it calculates. I mean, it does more than that, but that's what it was built to do. Its core functionality. It adds, subtracts, multiplies numbers. Big numbers. And it does things with those numbers. Like, have you ever watched the stars in the sky at night?
I'm not just a man with a sword.
Of course. And you've seen how those stars move across the sky. Using a calculating engine, we can actually track those stars and predict where they're going to be in a year from now, or a century, or where they were a century ago.
Why are you tracking stars?
Well, we're not. I mean, it's just an example. We're not actually tracking stars. I mean, sure, we could if we wanted to, but... We're tracking dreams.
Dreams?
Dreams are very complex. Which is why we need a big engine with lots of ticking parts to make complex calculations and predictions.
Right. So, the part about not just being a man with a sword... Assume that's all I am and start over.
Yes, fine. Those pipes crisscrossing the city, they're sort of like, like speaking tubes, connecting 100 sage masters, each with his or her own field of specialty.
So, it's like a university?
Well, I guess. Yes. Yes, this is a good comparison. A whole city filled with clever brains. The spheres pass messages between the different masters, and between them and us. We write messages, and we interpret messages. We tell the individual brains what to think about, and then they do the thinking and report back to us. Now, this allows us to write ever more complex messages until finally we have the code we need, the ultimate message. That one we send to the tower.
Why?
Because that's where the biggest brain of them all is located. This is the hub of the Pike Network, the engine's core, its heart, the nucleus of the meta... Well, you understand. The fact is, this is the most advanced and scientific task anyone's ever taken on, and we're doing it. You should be proud.
Why are you doing it?
Well, I don't quite know. Because we can? Because no one else can? Because the Prophet told us to, and gave us the tools to do it.
So, you don't know what it's for?
I write the instructions. I'm the man in the middle. Someone tells me what they need, and I tell the engine how to compute the answer. This is my job.
Who knows what the engine is for?
The Six, probably. The Prophet, certainly. Emissary Saya, I would imagine. This is above my pay grade.
Above your...
I was hired to write instructions for the engine and compute the spheres, not to ask questions. And not to answer yours either, Mir. You really should go before someone comes. We'll both be in terrible trouble. They usually check on me all the time. I wonder why they haven't.
I still don't understand. Why build all of this here in Mercuria? Why not in Sadir?
Because of the tower and what's below it. Vast eddies of, meta-energies.
Meta... Do you mean magic?
Magic? Magic? Of course not magic. This engine is the opposite of magic. It's the culmination of everything Azadir has strived for these last 100 years. An end to chaos and uncertainty. An end to superstition and irrationality. An end to magic. When the engine's fully operative and the programming complete, we won't need sorcerers or witchcraft anymore. We'll be able to do anything we want with science. Reshape reality, rewrite the laws of the cosmos, remove death and disease, poverty, and warfare. The world will be run by scientists for the betterment of humanity.
What do dreams have to do with it?
The engine feeds on the building blocks of reality. Ideas, stories, dreams. Magic is highly detrimental to the system. See, sorcery causes chaos, injects uncertainties and fallacies into our calculations.
So, is that why magicals
are being relocated? We can't have them around while the engine's calculating. But as soon as we're done...
believe they're being relocated?
Yes. Yes, of course. I mean, it's what they told us. Why would they lie? It's simple. The engine isn't compatible with magic. And we don't want anyone getting hurt. There's no room for sorcery in Mercuria. The magicals are better off in their new homelands.
They're being sent to prison camps.
Re-education camps. This is true, yes, but only temporarily. This is their first stop. Afterwards, they're given passage to their new homelands, where they can-
Do you really believe that? What would the magicals be re-educated to do? Forget that they're magicals? No, Ferdows. That's not the truth. They're imprisoned. Killed. They're not given a new home.
But they told us. They said they were... They promised they'd be safe and happy and... Oh, light protect them.
So this is why we're sending all the magicals away from Mercuria. Because of the engine.
Yes. Yes. That That's why. I didn't know. I didn't know. There are children.
There are.
They lied to us.
Do you need to remove all magicals before starting up this calculating engine?
It's already running. I'm not... As long as the thermoturgical interference is below the acceptable threshold for...
Pretend that I'm a very small and possibly very stupid child.
Oh. No. No, they don't need to get rid of all of the magicals. Just enough not to disrupt our calculations. We'll be done instructing the network in a couple of days. After that, they can pull a lever whenever they want. That's the last component of the engine. The tower. The one that will start feeding on and molding the dreams. Changing the world for the better. Yeah. I believe the official ceremony is a few days from now. The emissary will be there, together with the First and the Prophet, and please don't kill me.
I'm not going to kill you. But what you're doing here is not the will of the goddess, Fadaus. Something is going on. Someone's here. I had a feeling it was you. Mia? Goddess, what are you doing here, Hami? Where are your men?
Right outside. They can be here in seconds. You, engineer, what's your name?
I threatened him. He played no part in this.
Fadaus. I'm Fadaus. You lied.
I beg your pardon?
You promised they'd be safe.
I've no idea what you're talking about.
Go, Fadaus. This is not about you. Just remember what I told you. You're not doing the work of the goddess here.
Old Town was a distraction. Vamon meant it to be a struggle for my men to die. He wanted to take my mind off the investigation. Commander Vamon and the emissary have been lying to me about your death. Why is that?
Because I'm a danger to them. And it's not the only thing they've lied to you about. This engine...
You betrayed us. You joined the enemy.
To stop Sire and Vamon, not to fight our people. Not to fight you.
Sister Sire is the emissary. Commander Vamon is your superior officer. They are your people.
They are traitors, Mir. They have betrayed our nation, our faith, and...
You should have come to me first, Apostle. You should have come to me. Instead, you've shamed me. You've shamed Mother Utana, the Six, the Goddess, your nation. When I received word someone had been spotted entering this house, I had a feeling it was you. I entered alone for two reasons. One, as a courtesy to the mother. It would break her heart again to hear that you perished in dishonor, fighting my guard. And two, you're living proof that Vamon has lied to me. I cannot reveal my hand to Vamon, but I also cannot let you go. You'll surrender to me now, without struggle, and you'll be brought to Sadir tonight, in secret. The courts will decide your fate. For the time being, while I sort out this mess, you'll be locked away under a false name. No one will know you're alive. When I'm ready to confront the commander and the emissary with their lies, I will reveal the truth about your survival, and you will cooperate every step of the way.
Ask Sire and Vamon about the camps, and what they're doing to...
You lied. You lied to us. You told us they would not be harmed. You told us they'd be safe. There were children!
Get off me, you idiot!
Go! Go, Keon! Make them pay for this!
Stop that! Get off me! I'll have you beheaded for this.
Shadow, damn you, man! Leave this place! Now!
Was that actually enough to occupy him? He couldn't get away from that spindly engineer? That felt really awkward. I don't find that believable. That was weird. That was weird.
Yes?
Mother,
It's the General. He asks to speak with you.
Send him in, child. Hami, is anything the matter?
It's Kian. He's alive.
Oh! Goddess. Goddess, be praised. How do you know this?
He broke into the engine room down on City Green.
Light. What was he doing there?
Speaking with one of the engineers, Fadaus, a young man from the southern provinces. Kian said... Oh, well, it's of no consequence. He's a traitor. He's joined the resistance.
But...
It is as I suspected. We have been lied to by Vamon and the Emissary.
For what reason?
That I don't know. Yet. And until we do, we cannot confront the Mother.
I agree. We don't know how firm their grip is on the tower. If they know that we know... What about Kian? Was he... How did he look to you?
He looked strong. Different, but strong.
He must have his reasons for doing what he's doing, Hami. Kian would never betray Azadir or his faith.
Perhaps, but that's what he's doing. I gave him the honorable choice to turn himself in and face righteous judgment. But he fled like a coward when the engineer attacked me.
Attacked?
I don't blame the man. Kian poisoned his mind with baseless lies. My men detained him, and I've placed him somewhere safe, somewhere he can't tell anyone what he saw and heard. Out of Vamon's reach. We need to keep this between us, or we run the risk of alerting the commander and emissary Saya. Much as I'd like to hunt down Kian myself and put him to the sword, we must be patient.
Let's trust the goddess, Hami, to illuminate our path and bring us to the truth.
I certainly hope she will.
All right, well, I think that's a pretty good place to end this episode before we get into some more adventures. Yeah, that was not what I expected all those machines and orbs and stuff to be used for. That is not what I expected to find. I don't know exactly what I expected. But what I did not expect is some massive, primitive, sort of primitive, number-crunching computer. I say sort of primitive because on one hand it's obviously bigger and bulkier than... way, way bigger and bulkier than modern computers. But at the same time, it also somehow feeds off of meta-energies and reshapes dreams, which is a lot more advanced than any modern computers. So on one hand, it's bulkier and much larger and much more primitive, but on the other hand, it also seems to be more advanced and stranger. They're gonna use it to make a better world by what? Did he say it could reshape dreams, but it also fed off of dreams? And meta-energy is not the same as magic? Magic actually hurts its ability to function? I still don't exactly get how it works or exactly what the heck it's doing, but... I get the basic idea, and it's really strange. And even though it's, you know, as he said, meant to make everybody better, improve the world. Given who holds the reins of this machine, let's be honest, it's not going to be used for that. It's not going to be used for good. That's pretty much guaranteed. Yeah, whatever the hell it is, and whatever the hell it does, I think it needs to be stopped. I don't think anybody should have that power. Alright, so I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.